jury selection this morning and the jury trial that we're about to select for today. We will be drawing a jury for one criminal case this morning. In a moment, I'm going to tell you the name of the case, the names of the people involved, the date the trial will begin, and the approximate number of days it's expected to last. Please listen carefully to all of this information. If your name is drawn and you know anyone involved in this case or have a conflict with a particular date, then I'll have you approach the bench if your name is called so that we can discuss that further. Can you raise your hand if you cannot hear me? Okay, very good. We're now going to draw a jury in the matter of State of New Hampshire versus Adam Montgomery. In this case, the defendant is charged with 2 counts of armed career criminal, 2 counts of receiving stolen property, and 2 counts of theft by unauthorized taking. The charges read as follows. On the first count of armed career criminal, it states that Adam Montgomery, between approximately September 29, 2019 and October 22, 2019, did commit the crime of armed career criminal in that Adam Montgomery did knowingly have in his possession or under his control a rifle, having been convicted of any combination of 3 or more felonies in this state or in any other state under the applicable law. The second count of armed career criminal reads as follows. Adam Montgomery, between approximately September 29, 2019 and October 22, 2019, did commit the crime of armed career criminal, in that Adam Montgomery did knowingly have in his possession or under his control a shotgun, having been convicted of any combination of 3 or more felonies in this state or in any other state under the applicable law. The next charge is 1 count of receiving stolen property. This states that Adam Montgomery, between approximately September 29, 2019 and October 22, 2019, did commit the crime of receiving stolen property in that Adam Montgomery purposely received or retained the property of another, to wit, a shotgun firearm belonging to CF, knowing that it had been stolen or believing that it had probably been stolen with a purpose to deprive CF thereof. The second count of receiving stolen property reads as follows. Adam Montgomery, between approximately September 29, 2019 and October 22, 2019, did commit the crime of receiving stolen property, in that Adam Montgomery purposely received or retained the property of another, to wit, a rifle firearm belonging to CF, knowing that it had been stolen or believing that it had probably been stolen with a purpose to deprive CF thereof. The first count of theft by unauthorized taking or transfer reads as follows. Adam Montgomery, between approximately September 29, 2019 and October 3, 2019, did commit the crime of theft by unauthorized taking or transfer in that Adam Montgomery purposely obtained or exercised unauthorized control over the property of another, to wit, Montgomery stole a shotgun firearm from CF's residence with a purpose to deprive CF thereof. The second count of theft by unauthorized taking or transfer reads as follows. Adam Montgomery, between approximately September 29, 2019 and October 3, 2019, did commit the crime of theft by unauthorized taking or transfer in that Adam Montgomery purposely obtained or exercised unauthorized control over the property of another, to wit, Montgomery stole a rifle firearm from CF's residence with a purpose to deprive CF thereof. Those are the charges pending against the defendant for this trial. It is anticipated that this trial, will begin tomorrow at 9 a.m. It is estimated that this trial will last approximately 5 to 7 days. This is just an estimate. Cases sometimes move more quickly than anticipated or take longer than originally expected. Therefore, if selected for this case, you should plan accordingly. We will not have trial on Tuesday, June 6th. The case will continue on Wednesday, June 7th, and be held every day thereafter until completed. If anyone has a problem or particular conflict with the schedule for this case, such that you believe you would not be able to sit as a juror if selected, then if your name is drawn, please approach the bench so that we can discuss the reason for your conflict and whether the court will excuse you or seat you on the jury. As you may know, a jury in the Superior Court consists of 12 jurors. We will also seat 3 alternates, so 15 individuals will be impaneled. A determination will be made at the end of the case as to which jurors will serve as alternates and the jury foreperson. So if you are seated in seat 13, 14, or 15, don't assume that you are the alternate. We will select the alternates at random at the end of the case. As we begin this process, we will seat 21 potential jurors, and the lawyers will then have an opportunity to address you and ask you some additional questions. The purpose of the selection process that we are about to engage in is to ensure a fair trial. Jurors should be free of any prejudice or bias which might interfere with your ability to decide this case based solely on the evidence presented at trial and the law which will be given to you by the court in its instructions. Will counsel for the state please stand and introduce yourselves to the potential jurors? Will counsel for the defendant please stand and introduce yourselves to the jury?